styles, and kind of in conversation with the quality of film, what
capturing that does.
So I'm shooting at 16
lighting and motion of
the exploring
I'm interested in this idea
of
how
surfaces
film grain
and
might
fabrics
to
and
the
different materials
kind of
and
weft
filming that and
warp
the intersection of that
the fabric,
the actual film.
I mean, it seems mostly to attend to the spatial.
I have questions about time.
I kind of want to discover it as I go.
What,
I guess.
What do you intend
of,
to have?
Of what does that look like
with this material?
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's kind of the tricky part.
What
I really got
to
think of is get less hung up on
the
concept. One of the reasons that we're alive 16 positive years in the moment is because when you're in there with the Bolex, think about frame rate.
Think about how you can manipulate time in relationship to this fabric. You know, you can think about time even as a fabric. Right? Get in there,
get your hands in the material.
Hey, how's it going?
Yeah, that's going pretty good except for that cigarette.
What about it?
I'm not allowed to smoke within 30 feet of any college building entrance.
I don't mean to be disrespectful, but I've never heard of that policy actually being enforced before.
I mean, anybody walking through here has to smell that smoke.
I'm the only person out here.
Yeah, I know. That's college policy. It's going to have to be a write-up.
Are you serious?
Yep. What's your name?
Sam. I guess I just don't understand why this policy is being enforced now. That's pretty unfair. It's kind of ridiculous.
I'm sorry to feel that way.
In one continuous shot, Navidson, whom we never actually see, momentarily focuses on a doorway on the north wall of his living room before climbing outside of the house through a window to the east of that door, where he trips slightly in the flower bed, redirects the camera from the ground to the exterior white clapboard, then moves right, crawling back inside the house through a second window.
Campo crackdown. 30 feet away my ass.
You're telling me.
How are ya?
I'm fine. Actually, I think I'm kind of on the edge of something.
Kind of on the edge of something?
No, Emily, seriously. I shot this really beautiful thing for my project last night. I don't really know how to describe it. I was working with lights and fabrics, and you've seen the stuff I've been doing.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know, it just worked in this way that it never has before. Something clicked, and it was kind of hazy and gauzy. And I don't know, I've never shot anything like that. And I've been trying to tap back into whatever was working, but I've been shooting all day and whatever my camera was picking up on is gone. It's driving me crazy.
Spooky. Maybe you caught a ghost on camera like one of those photographers from the 1800s.
Oh, fuck off.
No, I'm serious. Bennington's creepy. We've all seen the freaky wheelchair in the Jennings basement. I think it's about time we had another ghost, don't you think?
I guess.
It's like this book I'm reading. You're like the Will Davidson of this campus. You've just shot the 5.5 minute hallway, except it's the 5.5 minute room 7 of Sato.
Wait, what is this book?
House of Leaves. Mark Danielewski. Well, there's this filmmaker, Will Davidson, and he shoots this closet that inexplicably appears in his house. And when he opens it, it's just a black void into extra dimensions, and it obsesses him. Don't let your ghost obsess you.
So, does he ever find out what it was or why it appeared?
Well, I haven't gotten there yet, but I will keep you posted. I actually have to keep reading. I'll see you later.
Okay. See you.
That I'm feeling and I've felt for most of the term with your work so far is you're just too in your head, you know? You don't make work in your head, you make it in the world. So you need to get out of your dorm, you need to get out of your house, maybe just take a walk. You think you can create moments like this, and they happen when you make yourself available to them, right? So if you have to invest the time in being out there and waiting for something to happen, it's not idle time. That's work.
Right, right, yeah.
So you gotta get out there.
Right. No, you're right.
Y'all familiar with Shirley Jackson?
Yes.
And so you know she taught school at Bennington, right?
At the college?
Yeah.
Are you interested in Shirley Jackson?
Yes, they are.
She's upstairs to the right. I'll show you where Shirley Jackson's bedroom is.
There you go.
And they had that case in the dining room there where the liquor's hanging out now. There were these little sort of carved skulls and skeletons and just some seriously spooky stuff.
Yeah, that's pretty spooky.
And a big collection of books on witchcraft where that painting is now.
The living room with all the big jack in it, that was all lined with books. It was floor to ceiling books. And I suppose it was the biggest selection of occult.
And then half of these arches were actually walled off so they could have more bookshelf. And so it was a very dark and mysterious house.
Yeah. But none of that scared you?
Oh, it did. Oh, yeah, it did as a kid. It's true. It definitely gave me the creeps.
Do you have any ghost stories?
I don't know.
Ghost
stories. Don't even understand it.
Ghosts.
But just be prepared to hear the story about the story, that the story itself may not be as interesting as what they think about ghosts. Do you know what I mean?
We had somebody rented that was staying here, kind of a renter, a couple of years ago, and she seemed to think she was seeing people.
What did she say? She said that she was seeing things.
She saw two older women arguing.
And the two mothers couldn't stand each other. And so they kind of divided the house into two portions so that everyone would have to interact. They would come into... they would come by different staircases into the kitchen at different times. And you know, kind of schedule each other's activities. So they kind of knew that that person was over here and that person was there, but they never saw each other.
Yeah. I've been kind of working on like some film projects up at the college, and I kind of this weird thing happened where I was filming in my room and I felt like I saw something
uh-huh.
there, but and it looks
like there's something on the footage.
It's very close to the road. It's a very short driveway. Maybe a car length driveway to the house. But it's kind of a Victorian type structure. Wood. Three stories. Just a thought.
But I don't really remember actually.
That's pretty cool.
It's kind of spooky, so I guess I've been hearing what other people have experienced, trying to figure that out a little bit.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I don't know. It's just never really happened to me, you know.
Yeah, and people were actually born in the house. They're born in the house, and then they died in the house.
Yeah.
So there's all those kinds of spirits.
There's no hospital.
There's, you know, probably 5 centuries of stuff in there.
A woman mysteriously disappeared there in the 40s. I think she was a Bennington College student, actually.
Oh, really?
But I don't know much about the ghosts here. All I know is that they exist. Mm-hmm. Everybody seems to be interested in ghosts.
So, like I was saying, House of Leaves is getting crazy. I mean, I was doing research on some of the citations, and I do mean some because there are like hundreds of them. And they exist. The citations actually exist. I mean, the author did all of this research on architecture and filmmaking and even fucking physics. And then this nonfiction thing comes up that's actually just a foil for the pseudo nonfiction of the Navidson record. You know, although I don't really know, like, how much good it does for anybody if the author is just showing off how intelligent and well-read he is. Like, it's self-awareness, but what good is self-awareness of the author in a novel? Sam?
You hear anything I just said?
Yeah. I have to go.
You look terrible. You've been working on this project nonstop. You should take a break.
Yeah. You're right. I will.
Dean Navidson to reinvestigate, once again leading us on another circumambulation of this strange passageway. Climbing in and out of windows, pointing the camera to where the hallway should extend, but finding nothing more than his own backyard.
Different ghost stories, but I've always heard ghost stories. And I feel like by now the ghost story itself is just Bennington's campus. I mean, like, there's a story about every single place on this campus.
I've had officers over the years who are reluctant to go to Jennings late at night because they feel that they exist and that they're there. I myself had no experiences. Then again, I'm not necessarily a firm believer in the supernatural. But I certainly can understand the concerns and the history people have in this place as it relates to particularly some of the buildings like Jennings, which lends itself to a very foreboding physical experience to be in.
I can't really say I know anything about ghosts. I can have my theories, sure. Cross-dimensional sort of activity, which, you know, it's a theory. It's just something that I thought of, but...
Do I think they're real? Probably in some way. I like ghost movies.
What are you doing? Are you filming me? Go away. I don't want to be filmed right now. Go away. Leave me alone. Stop filming me. Thank you.
Please, have a seat anywhere you like. Any chair is fine.
Creative choice. I usually sit in that chair, but don't have to. Did say wherever.
Sorry, do you want me to move?
No, please.
Wherever's most comfortable. So, Sam, you know why you're here today?
Yep. I was smoking in my room, and I set off the fire alarm.
That's one way of putting it, yeah. I would phrase it a little differently. You sacrificed your safety and the safety of everyone around you, not only by poisoning your lungs and polluting the air that everyone on this college campus has to breathe, but also by introducing a severe fire safety hazard into your room. An unprecedented amount of apathy towards the health and well-being of others.
Unprecedented? Are you serious? People set off the fire alarm all the time.
Not like this. And for what, Sam? To deepen your dependence on cigarettes?
I know that I broke a rule. And I know that smoking isn't allowed inside and that Campo is trying to crack down.
Do you have any idea the damage cigarette smoke has on pine?
No, but the $500 fine kind of gives me an idea.
And after getting a violation for the exact same thing you did last week, you'd think you'd learn by now, Sam. I don't know. Help me out here. Is there something that I'm missing?
I'm scared to leave my room at night. Okay, I know this is gonna sound crazy, but I don't know, there's this thing, like a ghost or something, and it's been following me around.
You're scared of a ghost? But not the 43 carcinogens and 400 other chemical toxins that are in cigarettes.
Okay,
I'm sorry, Sam.
I
can't see the logic
in
that.
I'm not making this up. I can prove it to you. I caught it on camera. And whatever it is, that it's still out there.
Listen, I really have no interest in playing these little games to make you feel better. You're just here for me to tell you that if you smoke inside a building or within 30 feet of a building ever again on this campus,
you will face potential suspension and a call home to your parents.
Just looking out for your safety, Sam. Smoking kills. Now, do you want me to set up an appointment with psychological services about all this ghost business? You can either drop the act or seek help.
I'll be fine. Thanks.
I think this was a really good chat we had here today. Now, Sam, please, stay out of trouble, and please, take care of yourself. When students on this campus hurt themselves, it hurts me too, you know? You can go now.
Consistently seen this woman who will stand at the top of their stairs, and she's wearing like a funeral gown. Well, they think that she pushed her baby down the steps, and that's why she stands there staring at them.
My friend Julia lives in Bingham, and she has a ghost in her room who likes to play around by unplugging things or unscrewing light bulbs, sometimes locking the door.
You know who you want is Maeve.
Yeah, Maeve.
Is she around?
Okay. No, she lives up there.
Where I'd wake up in the room and my roommate was somebody else who I didn't know.
I saw a ghost in my room at the Welling townhouse about 2 weeks ago, and it was very tall and made of light, and it was looking at me.
A couple friends and I did a Ouija board in my room. We figured out that it was a little girl, and she had died, I think somewhere near campus, somewhere in North Bennington.
It felt kind of malevolent, certainly. Sort of like maybe a demon, I don't know.
You think you'd be able to find it again if you wanted to look for it?
I don't know why you'd want to find something like that again.
And we tried again, and Tristan was like, this is someone else, this is not. Like, this is scary, this is someone else, this is the person that was stopping her from talking. And so then we started talking to someone saying that he was an adult. He had been killed by a train in North Bennington. And I got so freaked out because this was my room and I had to go to bed when everybody left.
Dewey 14 apparently has a ghost in it. I was told that it is a girl who hung herself. Not in Dewey 14, but she lived there. I was told to just like let her be, just like say hi to her sometimes, everything would be fine. And I know the girls who live there now apparently see her all the time.
And we did a Ouija board in what's now the second card room and talked to a woman who said that she lived in one of the rooms and it was quite sweet.
There was a woman who lived there? A long time ago?
I guess so.
Is she still around?
I mean, I don't think anybody this term has experienced anything freaky.
Does it go anywhere else? Does it stay there?
Yeah, I would say near the common room.
Have you ever, like, seen a ghost or communicated with a ghost and been able to find it again?
No. When I lived in Booth, I was convinced that there was a ghost in my room because I kept feeling like someone was sitting on my feet, and the windows would slam and my like garbage can would move.
But you don't feel like if you see something once you don't see it again.
No,
but it's still out there, right?
I mean,
whatever it was that you saw.
I would say maybe.
Yeah.
about to go smoke?
You look like shit.
Thanks.
You okay?
I'm going crazy. The admin is insane. They called me in to lecture me about smoking and threatened to call my parents.
That's not okay.
That ghost that I saw is fucking real. I've been trying every single night to recreate that shot, and I get nothing. I try different angles and exposures and lighting combinations, and I still get nothing. I don't know how to finish my film now. Because even if I could somehow summon this ghost again, is it even worth it? I don't know, because I don't really want to mess with something that I know nothing about. And it's kind of freaking me out and haunting my thoughts, because all the time I'm just thinking, what is it going to do next? Where is it going to be? When is it coming back?
Sam, there's no ghost. You know that, right? I was joking.
No, there is a ghost. I've asked people on this campus, and I've asked people in town, and there is a ghost.
Stop freaking out. I mean, you're pulling a real Davidson right now. The only reason this ghost exists is because of this film that you're making. Now, you can chase it around until you go fucking crazy, or you can let it go. Go smoke in the field or something. Relax.
I don't want to go out there. I've been hearing and seeing shit.
Sam, there's nothing in that field except for, like, a couple of frogs. You need to bring yourself back down to reality. I mean, if you're that scared, bring a flashlight. Or your camera. I mean, maybe that's where you'll find your next magic shot.
Maybe you're right.
Now, calm down.
Dimming, its light suddenly spent, the book is gone, leaving nothing behind.